it's you. Well, what do you make of it? What's happened to this village? I witnessed a sight much the same in my infancy. The oppression of the weak. Murder and pillage unchecked. A waking nightmare made by men. But this time, I'm a woman grown. And though the suffering cannot be undone, I can still mete out justice. Justice to the oppressors. Let the scars I carve remind them. I am Nefeli Lu, warrior. But this time, and though the suffering can justice to let the scars up.
No, dear me. I haven't a clue. No secrets lie with me, not a one. Oh, please leave me be. Wait then. You're not one of them. Well, what a relief. Oh, goodness me. I am Albus. An Alvinoric. As you can see, we're finished. The whole village is finished. The curse mongers have destroyed everything. No one that remains has their wits about them. I beg you. Would you look after this medallion? You must keep it out of the curse mongers' hands. And if you should meet the young Alvinoric Latena, then please give it to her. A chosen land awaits us, Alvinorics. The medallion is the key that leads to the city. It's only a quaint treasure for we who cannot make the journey. But for dear Latena, it is needed to fulfill her purpose. My legs will soon fade, and with them my life. Alas, this is the immovable fate of all Alvinorics.
appear to be doing well. Very good. Well then, would you like to learn an incantation? May the golden orb...
Journey to the capital, Lendell.
The two fingers will do.
You maybe. Oh, my apologies for that nasty business. Ensha got rather ahead of himself, it seems. As his master, I'd like to express my regret. But now, Ensha is slain and gone. Finished. Forevermore. Ah, yes. By way of apology, allow me to tender some advice in regard to the half of the secret medallion you possess. Find the Albinoric woman. She hides in a cave to the west of the Lascia ruins, which jut from the mist-shrouded lake of Liurnia. She knows the location of the medallion's counterpart, I am sure. Find the Albinoric woman. She hides in a cave to the west of the Lascia ruins, which jut from the mist-shrouded lake of Liurnia. She knows the location.
Always good to see you safe. So, what do you need?
This is a black knife print. I can scarcely believe you managed to get your hands on this. You recall our conversation about the Knight of the Black Knives, yes? They say the assassins who carried out the deed were Scions of the Eternal City. A group entirely of women, arrayed in armor of silver under cloaks which fooled the eye. The knives they wielded, though, were imparted with the power of the Rune of Death through sinister rite. Please, I beg of you, lend me the knife print for a time. I'd love nothing more than to tease out its secrets. Though only a fragment, a very specific ritual had to be performed to impart the power of the Rune of Death. Traces of the one who performed the rite are sure to remain in the imprint. Half my body has been suffused with death. I'm certain it will help me see.
Well, I took you for no matter. Lay out your arms.
punished. Bring more deaths. I shall grant thee eye and claw. Feed me more.
You've met Garank, I take it. Then owing to our duties shared, we are now comrades in arms. I think you've earned this. The power of the Golden Order to aid the hunt of those who live in death. Are you acquainted with a man named Roger? You know, the piteous fellow hiding away on the balcony. He was a formidable spellblade in times past. Don't let his easy air deceive you. He was wise beyond his years, stout of heart, and clear of mind. No more, though. You see him now, ravaged by thorns, muttering and rambling, like he's half dead already. I can't stomach to watch. Take well the lesson, friend. That's how you end up. When seduced by those who live in death. When grace is sullied, it rots people from the inside. Breaks them. I serve the Golden Order, that I might put this crooked land to rights, following only the guidance of the Great Elden Ring. Those who live in death fall outside the principles of the Golden Order. Their mere existence sullies the guidance of gold, tainting its truth. And so it is, the vermin must be exterminated, down to the very last.
You. Please, leave me be. It's pathetic, I know, but I need to think. You. Please, it's pathetic, I know.
Journey to the capital.
The two fingers will...
You may be our best. You've already heard. Indeed. It seemed the whelp harbored suspicions, so I had no further use for her. Honestly, what's a man to do? A determined plebeian is more wicked than an omen horn, quite frankly. I suspect that's just what the Queen wants. A dose of ambition. To incite the tarnished.
You. Please. It's pathetic, and... So you know already, do you? Right. It's true. My father cast me out, for indulging my emotions, forgetting the mission. Punishment for offing his pawns. Father, rather, Lord Gideon has offered me guidance all my life. I would have done anything for him, to place him on the throne of Elden Lord. And yet I, though it was not my intent, I betrayed him. And I can no longer trust him, Father, to think he'd order his men to enact such tragedy. Where is the justice he purports in that? He once told me that if he became Elden Lord, he would never allow the downtrodden to be cheated ever again. Was he simply lying to me? No, no, no. How could I say that? Father has always given me his guidance. And now, I've lost it. Is that ash? I can smell the ancient storm in it. My thanks. I'll gladly take it. I'm not like Roderica. I don't feel the presence of spirits, let alone see them. Still, this ash, it reminds me of my first hawk. Thank you. In this ash, it reminds me of...
See you again. Would you like me to hold you once? Now. You are so very warm. I heard that you lent a hand. Dear Roger, he seemed positively elated. He must be possessed of great mental fortitude. It anchors his will and sustains him, despite his grievous wounds. You truly are a champion to dear Roger and myself too. Then good day to you, my dear.
All right.
You claimed a great room and had your own watch. Aha. My doubts. The words of the two fingers cannot be trusted. Truly. Nought I believe. But when the Elden Ring... Even worse. That's the part that... Oh, I have a gift. A means for circum... Give it a try. And if it please, I've high hope.
Oh, well. It's been a long while.
It's me. Patches.
I'm still in business, if you can believe it. Now I'm my only supplier. So I have a Patches Emporium. By the way, have you met that girl, Raya? She's a strange one. Not that it's any of... If she rings your bell, why not lend her an ear? You're making your way to the Erd Tree, no? Well, I heard something that might help. Have you ever seen an Iron Virgin? The clunky contraptions are whirlwinds of sickles and spiked wheels. But long ago, they were endowed with a spell of transposition. And get this. A surviving virgin sits at the bottom of its transpositional power. So ripe, if it'll chuck you out straight at the basin. Oh yeah, there's a surviving iron, and I heard. Try to find it.
foul tarnished. What do you want? I told the all-hearing brute that I possess no such medallion. Or have you come to take more from me? Was my other half not enough? Do you speak true? So old Albus entrusted his medallion to you. Then I've no choice but to trust that this was his dying will. Let's try again. I'm Latena. An Albinoric, the same as old Albus. My apologies for my coarse words earlier. I presumed the worst. Seeing that you're another tarnished like that all-hearing brute, I hope that you will forgive me. The medallion's better off in your hands anyway. Would you consider doing me a great service? I must go back. There is something I must do. Even if I must say farewell to my wolf, Loba, will you show me the way? To the land of Mikola's Halig Tree. If you accept, I would gladly apprise you of the whereabouts of the medallion's other half. Thank you kindly. They say the other half of the medallion is beyond the Forbidden Lands, north of the Erd Tree, in Castle Sol, on the mountaintops of the Giants, accessible by the Grand Lift of Rold. Then I suppose it's time. Farewell, Lobo. My faithful wolf. My better half. I will go with the Tarnished, so that our journey will not have been in vain. Forgive me, Lobo. Call upon me when needed, and I will fight at your side.